What's going on, everybody? I'm James Young with jamesyoungphotography.com, and this is Teach Me How to Lightroom. Today, we're diving in how to get that moody, high contrast edit on boudoir photos. This is where we're starting, and this is where we're gonna end up. Super high contrast, bringing out all the shadows, making it real moody and accentuating the look of boudoir photography. Now, don't forget, there is a free download for the raw file of this exact image, so you can follow along and reach these results at the same time. So let's get this reset and into the edit. So first off, I wanted to address the white balance in this image. It's actually already edited. But we can see if we go to as shot, this shot came in super cold. So I'm gonna go back to custom and show you the white balance that I dialed in. So here we are. I brought it to about 4,300. And you can see that the image is much more warm and exactly where it needs to be in terms of the temperature. So as we make our way down the basic module, I'm not gonna change the exposure on this. I'm happy where it landed. And we're really gonna crank up the contrast in this, about plus 60. Awesome, and as we continue our way down, we hit our highlights. We're gonna do this about minus 25 or so. We're gonna open up our shadows a little bit, about plus 25 on that. We'll bring our whites down just a hair, and then lower, and then raise our blacks just a little bit as well, about plus 15 on those. As we hit presence, it's super important right here. Don't add any clarity. It's just gonna make things look more and more terrible as you slide to the right. Don't do that to people. They don't deserve that type of treatment. We will introduce more contrast with the dehaze slider. So we're gonna do about plus 20 here. Boom. Now with our vibrance, we're gonna cut this down a little bit here. We're gonna do about minus 20. That's just gonna attack more of the colder tones in the image. And then our saturation, we're gonna bring that down about minus 5, just kind of take the edge off the saturation. Awesome, so we've already made big strides. So let's make our way down to the tone curve, and we're actually gonna use one of the Lightroom presets on this. So right down here, it says point curve, linear. This is actually a drop-down menu, so if you click it, you can select strong contrast, and that's what we're going for. So a super easy tone curve for this edit. Now we make our way to our color grading, the HSL, the hue, saturation, and luminance section. We're not really gonna address anything in the hue section, but for our saturation, we are gonna do a little bit of work here. So for our saturation, our oranges, we're gonna bring this down just a little bit. Now, you gotta be careful with this because orange is typically where the skin tones are held, so you don't wanna do too much damage to this, right? So if you take it down too low, it looks awful. Now she looks like a zombie. Let's not do that. Minus 15 just takes the edge off the saturation of the orange tones. We're gonna bring our yellows down just a hair as well. Somewhere around minus 30 or 40, about minus 40 there. Now, just in case we have any green tones in the image, I'm gonna cut those down substantially, about minus 70. Then for our aquas, our blues, and our purples, we're gonna arc that down as well. We really want to eliminate the colder tones from this image. We'll even tackle the magenta some there too. Then we're going to do a similar slider pattern with our luminance. So we're going to bring our oranges down just a little bit, minus 10. Remember, this is where the majority of our skin tones are at. So if you do something like this, no, that looks even worse than killing the saturation. Don't do that. So we're going to bring our yellows down a tad, really bring down our greens. Really bring down our aquas, our blues, and our purples. Now you can see kind of what we've done with the color grade here. If we turn this off and turn it back on, looks really, really good. So we're gonna continue our work with the color grading here as we make our way down to split toning. So we wanna introduce some of the warmth that we took out of the image. So in our hue, we're gonna go to about 50. And then our saturation, we're gonna go to about 10. And then for our shadows, we're going to do 45 and then only do about 5 on the saturation there. Then in the middle here, we have balance. And this just allows us to choose which side gets more of the effect. So as we turn it to the left, the highlights get more of the effect. And as we go to the right, the shadows get more of the effect. So we're gonna apply that to the shadows by sliding it to the right about 45. So then let's take a look what we've done with split toning by turning this off and turning it back on. Oh, makes those skin tones look so much better. And that's the basis of the edit. We can do a few more things to round out the image, like making it sharper, doing some noise reduction here. We can even do a slight vignette that wouldn't look too bad, but I'm not gonna do that. You can even make it look more moody by introducing grain to the image, but I don't like ruining my photos, so I'm not going to add any grain. But you can take it from there and really take any spin you want on it. So if you downloaded the raw file and you did your own edit, I would love to see what you did. Post it on social media, tag me. I love seeing all your guys' edits. It's super cool to meet you guys, quote unquote, on social media land. So if you learned something and you like this video, please leave a like on the video. And if you're new and you learned something, it would be awesome if you subscribe to the channel. I'm James Young with JamesYoungPhotography.com, and this is Teach Me How to Lightroom.